ever since NASA successfully landed the first humans on the moon in 1969, humanity has looked towards its next big accomplishment in space. It is no surprise that one of the priorities in the space after the moon has been for the exploration of the red planet Mars. The hypothetical concept to colonize Mars has been under the radar of many public and private space agencies for some time now and has received extensive interest recently. First of many organizations to have proposed plans for a human mission on Mars include NASA and SpaceX. We will mainly talk about these two giant space agencies in this video and their ambitious plan to colonize Mars. No person has ever set a foot on the red planet, however, there have been many successful missions to send rovers on the surface of the planet. These rovers are crucial to gain the ground conditions data of the red planet. Just recently, on 18 February 2021, NASA successfully landed another rover called Perseverance on Mars. The rover's main aim is to find past environments that were capable of supporting microbial life. Colonizing Mars could be dangerous and expensive. NASA aims to complete the human landings on Mars by mid-2030s. On the other side, the business tycoon and CEO of SpaceX, Elon Musk, thinks otherwise. He has spent nearly two decades preparing for missions on Mars. His ambitious plans include landing the first humans to Mars as early as 2024. Before any organization can land humans on Mars, they will need to overcome some very difficult challenges, including getting to Mars, setting up a base, and producing food and water in a hostile and unknown environment. Mars is about 225 million kilometers from Earth and will take about 6 months to travel there. A rocket to go that far will need a lot of fuel. To overcome this challenge, SpaceX is working on a prototype called Starship rocket, a craft capable of taking off and waiting in an orbit to be refueled by a second Starship launch rocket already available in the orbit. Colonization of the red planet is the biggest challenge. It will require the establishment of permanent habitats and the creation of an environment capable of supporting and sustaining life. The main obstacle to colonize the planet is the atmosphere, climate, water, and soil. The challenges. Mars's atmosphere is so thin that no person can survive without pressure suits. And besides this, Mars's atmosphere is 95% carbon dioxide and only 0.1% oxygen, making it toxic for humans to breathe. Due to a thin atmosphere, a high amount of solar flares and radiations reaches Mars's surface. The climate of Mars is much colder than Earth, and Mars has no rain and virtually no clouds. Because of this, one advantage colonists will have is the use of solar panels. They will be able to work at maximum efficiency for days. The Martian soil is toxic as well due to relatively high concentrations of chlorine, which are hazardous to all forms of life. Water on Mars is scarce, so scarce that the recent rovers there found less water on Mars's surface than the driest desert of Earth. Colonization. Human survival on Mars would need living in artificial Mars's habitats with complex life support systems. For colonization, one of the key systems that needs to be in place is the water processing system. NASA-funded engineers are studying a way to build potential human habitats there by producing bricks from pressurized Martian soil. Apart from harmful radiations, gravity on Mars would also negatively affect human health by weakening bones and muscle. To tackle this issue, astronauts will need to wear some special kind of suits, and upon returning to Earth, they will need to be monitored under serious medical recovery process. Right now, the concept of colonization of Mars might sound fictional. The challenges needed to overcome are far too many today. But many scientists and engineers are working towards turning this fiction into reality in our lifetime, and we may see its result later if not sooner. With that being said, Elon Musk is very optimistic. In 2015, he stated, "I think we have got a decent shot of sending a person to Mars in 11 or 12 years." If you would like to see some more of this, be sure to check out my previous videos and don't forget to subscribe. If you have some video suggestions, comment down below.